Hello and welcome to a new episode of Victoria 3 A to Z. Today we are once again playing in Uganda, this time as Bunyoro. Now I would say the most defining characteristic of the Lake Victoria countries is their technology. Yeah, they have absolutely no tech, they have only the most basic of things. That's really what makes this start extremely hard. So I was thinking it would be pretty funny if we try to create a technocracy in this situation, although for that we'll need central archives, which is pretty far away. But for now I think I'll go for academia, just so we can build more universities and get the intelligentsia really powerful. And let's also bolster them. And let's get some appointed bureaucrats, since the leader of the landowners is a democrat. Let's get a couple degrees and a lot of taxes. I also want to conquer the other countries in the region, but they are really powerful. So of course we'll have to build up a bigger army. And let's make sure we improve with the Europeans, with Britain and France. I guess I could try to attack Ankole, they are pretty weak. Yeah, let's try it. And let's also get some conscripts. I think I'll let them attack me first, and then I'll do a counterattack. Okay, that was really easy. But now we don't have any manpower, so it will take a little bit until we recover. And we enacted appointed bureaucrats. Now I might want to get those guys in government, the rural folk, and try to maybe pass tenant farmers. Homesteading would be way too much, but tenant farmers might pass. Now I guess we can start building some logging camps as well. And some more plantations maybe, let's get one of everything. Also, looks like everybody is going to war in this region of Ethiopia. Okay, we actually managed to get it, tenant farmers. Now that's amazing, because that means we can also get an education. Yeah, the literacy must go up. And I guess now we can also go for Acholi. We should be able to beat them. Another one bites the dust. Popular playwright endorses reform. I will take the prestige, but unfortunately now it only lasts for 5 years. It's not permanent anymore. And I think now we can also afford the construction sector. And we got academia unlocked. I'll just keep researching society stuff. I think I can build an academia, although I don't have any paper. I can't even build any paper mills. And we finally got religious schools. Okay, manufacturing unlocked. Now we can finally build some paper mills. And some other stuff, such as tooling workshops. And furniture. And textiles. Okay, what's exactly going on here? How did I manage to trigger corn laws? I'm an isolationist economy. I can't even add tariffs on grain or anything. So I have no idea how this managed to trigger. I'm pretty sure you need mercantilism for that. But okay, fine, I'm not complaining. Apparently we also got a modern conservative. Okay, that's amazing. Let's make him the leader of the landowners. And now we can actually go for interventionism. I will try to rush stock exchange, maybe we can also get free trade with this guy. Interventionism was enacted. Now if I bring the peasants in government, I could actually pass homesteading. And we also got higher learning, because of the universities. Okay, sure, more technology. Now I think it's time to conquer another country. Yeah, this should be really easy. And now we got a second state. Yeah, I think I'll incorporate it. And homesteading was also enacted. Stock exchange. That means we can get free trade. I'm definitely gonna do it. I actually expanded my army quite a lot in the last years. So maybe now I'm ready to go against Buganda. This is gonna be a hard one. Okay, I'm repairing them. And my counterattack should be successful. That's great. We also got free trade. Well, yeah, those are some amazing laws. Now I would like to get the intelligentsia in government. And let's try to get freedom of conscience for now. Let's end this war. And now we can go for Burundi. And the devout want to rise up all of a sudden. Okay, you know what? If you want to rise up, I'll give you a reason to rise up. I'm separating church and state. And I will also need some more government administrations. Our bureaucracy is not looking too good. And the civil war started at the worst possible time. Because I didn't manage to finish off Burundi, so yeah, this is gonna be interesting. Okay, you know what, it doesn't matter, I'll beat both of them. Okay, actually, you know what, everybody is dying right now, so I might have to just white piece with those guys. I just don't have the manpower right now to deal with them. We actually unlocked the ability to build mines, and I think I would like to build a couple of them, especially iron, so that we can switch to iron frame buildings. Now I would say it's time for another war. I managed to recover all my manpower, so those guys will not stand a chance. That was extremely easy. Now I think I'm ready to switch to iron frame buildings, although we'll have a couple shortages, and it will cost a little bit of money. At least that civil war was not all in vain. We managed to separate church and state. This should really cripple the influence of the devout. Yeah, now we're really starting to have a lot of infrastructure problems, so I think it's time to move towards some railways. And let's also build a steel mill. And looks like a lot of people want to get national militia, and I think I'll do it. But first, I really want to get rid of Burundi. It's definitely time for you to go. And now I'm going for national militia. And now we managed to unite this entire region, which took way longer than I was expecting. And that's all because you didn't hit the like button, so you should do it right now. And I should build some more government administrations. The Uganda eruptions. I had absolutely no idea there are volcanoes in Uganda. Let's also increase the education investment. We now have national militia. I would say this is a bit better, since now we don't have to pay for our army. Now I guess I'll bring the intelligentsia back in government. And I will try to get some cultural exclusion. I don't think anybody will be mad about this. Now I can also build the motor industry, and I think I'll do that. We also discovered rubber in this region. That might become useful in the future. And those guys might actually get us in another civil war. Okay, you know what? Fine. Let's do it. They don't even have any units, so there is absolutely nothing to worry about. And now we actually got cultural exclusion. And since we are already at war with the devout, I might as well go for public schools right now. And the civil war is in fact over. We finally managed to get railways unlocked. Now we can fix all of our many infrastructure problems. We really need this. Now British East Africa expanded so much, we now connect with them. So that means we can do some trade with them. And we can also get a trade agreement. However, we can't join their market for some reason. Although our markets are connected. I think it's because I have a border with one of their subjects. And not them directly. So yeah, that's kind of stupid. Well, at least we got public schools. And also water to boil. That's pretty good as well. Now I think I'll change my government to this. Because I want to get some per capita taxation. And we got central archives unlocked. That means we can finally go for a technocracy. But I think I'll first get per capita and then I'll do that. In the meanwhile, there is a lot more tech we can get. Such as pharmaceuticals. Or modern sewage and central banking. Now I also see we don't really have any peasants left, so maybe I should also try to open the borders to get some migration in. Yeah, I guess I'll think about it. And also the industrialists want to pass poor laws, so yeah, I have to pass a lot of laws. And now we can even get a defensive pact with Britain for an obligation. Okay, fine, I'll do it. I don't see why not. Okay, and now actually Britain invites me in their customs union. For sure I'm gonna accept. It took a bit of time, but somehow we finally made our way to the British market. That's amazing. Okay, now we actually got per capita. And I thought hard about this, but I think my main concern right now will be opening the borders. Which might cause a civil war, but it's gonna be worth it. Come on, start the civil war, I dare you. Okay, whatever, I have the entire British Empire on my side. And we can also establish our first company. I think I'll get this one. The Iron Company. We open the borders. Now I'm expecting a lot of migration. And now I think it's finally time to go for a different governing system. Let's become a technocracy. Yeah, well, that's kind of underwhelming. I think we'll get more eventually. Okay, I think this might get better with those mass migration. And we did it, we finally became a technocracy. Although we have some of the worst technology in the entire game. Now I think I'll also switch from monarchy to a parliamentary republic. Let's see how that goes. This will definitely cause a civil war. Now we have a 100% chance of this passing. And the civil war is over. I actually maxed out my logging camps in both of my states. So now let's also max out the iron mines, why not? And then looks like the British market needs a lot more engines. So I'm also gonna build a lot more of those. Oh, and looks like Germany went communist. They are a vanguard state. And now it's time to establish our second company. And I think the motor industry bonus would be really good. And in the future, I would also like a steel mill company. Okay, we became a parliamentary republic. That's amazing. But for some reason, our ex-emperor is still in charge. However, he can be resigned from office. And I think I'll do that. Should we have an election to choose the next leader? Okay, sure. And this guy, the industrialist, is now in charge. Well, now let's get some poor laws. Oh, and also I've been investing a whole lot into my police institution. I just don't want to deal with any turmoil. And now we have some big authority problems. So maybe we should stop bolstering the intelligentsia now. I mean, we already became a technate, so I think it's fine. Oh, and also Scandinavia formed up here, and now they're going to war with Germany. Poor laws enacted. And now I should really address the slavery problem. I kinda forgot about it, but it has to be banned. Okay, now I think I might actually disband this company, this metal company. And instead I will get the steel company, because it gives us 5% construction efficiency on any building. So let's do it. And man, for some reason we are really having a tough time banning slavery. Well, at least we can increase the education, I guess. Oh, Italy is also here now. Parma is actually the one who formed Italy. Pretty cool. Okay, now we actually got human rights unlocked. So that means now we can go for feminism. And that will be quite interesting. Finally, after 600 years we managed to get slavery banned. It was about time. Now what else can we go for? Guaranteed liberties would be kinda nice. Okay, this one we actually got pretty quickly. Now I could try to go on laissez-faire for that extra company, but I'm not too sure I'll be able to succeed, since the industrialists don't really like this. But okay, I guess I can try. And we got feminism unlocked, which is definitely amazing. So I'll try to get some kind of humanitarian, or enlightened royalist leader. Yeah, it will take a while. Okay, we got a humanitarian, which is actually pretty popular. So let's recruit him. Let's get the intelligentsia out of government. And then I have to wait 22 months in order to exile this guy. Yeah, I forgot about that part. I guess we'll have to wait a little bit. And we also got steel frame buildings. Okay, now we can probably also switch to steel frame buildings. And unfortunately, laissez-faire has failed. Now, of course, I want to get a humanitarian in charge of the intelligentsia. But I can't exile this guy because his ideology is too similar to that of our ruler. So I think I'll have to resign this guy from office. But I wonder who will take his place. Okay, let's try to choose this one. Okay, and then we get the trade unions in charge of the government. And now I could try to exile this guy. And the humanitarian will probably become the leader. Yes, just like I said. Now let's try to create this government, I guess. And only now we can go for multiculturalism. We definitely have to get it. And that government just became illegitimate. It's really hard to form a new one. Yeah, I guess this should work. At least for a little bit. Oh, and also I maxed out my coal mines as well. Now I don't have any other resources I can build. Until I unlock rubber. Okay, and passing multiculturalism will definitely mean a civil war. There is no way around it. Okay, and and those guys who oppose multiculturalism were defeated. Now I would say this is the perfect government. Okay, now we finally also unlocked rubber, so it's time to build some. There we go, we actually got it, we enacted multiculturalism. Now no one will be discriminated in our country. Now let's also get some compulsory primary school. Okay, and our migration should really start going crazy now. Yeah, now we built up all of our resources, we can't build anything else, other than industry. But that's fine, I guess. Actually, we also discovered rubber in Uganda, so let's also build this up. Yeah, now this company is having a really rough time, so I think I'm gonna disband it. And instead, I will re-establish the premium metals company. Okay, now we can actually establish another company. Okay, I think I'll pick the paper company, just for the bureaucracy bonus. And after so much time, I was finally able to get compulsory primary school enacted. Now we can max out our education institution. And next, I think I'll go for women in the workplace. That might cause another civil war, actually. Now I can actually join this war in India, on the side of the British. And they will owe me an obligation, so let's join. And the civil war started in my country as well. Now women are also allowed to work, but now the birth rate really went down, and it's getting pretty close to the mortality rate, since yeah, we do have a lot of pollution, so we should really do something about it, such as getting the trade unions in government, and getting some public health insurance. Electrical generation unlocked. I don't usually play with electricity too much, so yeah, I think we should give it a try. Let's first introduce electric streetlights. Now let's also get some electric fences, and maybe even some electric sawmills. This will be a lot of electricity. Yeah, we'll have to build more power plants. Now we got a stable supply of power. Yeah, now we not only developed all of our natural resources, but we are also using all of our arable land in both states. Now we can literally only build industry. And unfortunately, public health insurance completely failed. So I guess I'll go for the second best thing, which is private health insurance. I guess it's better than nothing. Finally, we got some kind of a healthcare system. Let's upgrade this all the way to the max level. Now I think I'll get commercialized agriculture. And now we managed to reach 10 million population. And those guys might actually start a revolution because they want democracy. Well, too bad, they are not gonna get it. Well, that revolution is over. Now we also got commercialized agriculture. Now I can't really go for anything else I want. But hey, at least we unlocked automobiles, so we can start building them. This should make the motor industries more profitable. And we also just unlocked the telephone. So why not, let's start building some electronics industries. Okay, now I think I might go from interventionism to laissez-faire. Okay, actually this might start another revolution. So I think I'm not gonna do it. Interventionism is not that bad, actually. Now in case you're wondering what happened to the rest of the world, the French and the British colonized most of Africa. Ethiopia remains divided in two. Meanwhile in Europe we have a united Italy. North Germany formed and they ditched communism. France controls the Rhineland again. And that's about it. The British have also expanded a whole lot in Asia, in Persia, in Tibet, in Siam, and even in the Philippines. Meanwhile, the Americas are looking pretty normal, with a few exceptions, such as the fact that Brazil took La Paz. Yeah, overall, the world is pretty normal. So let's go back to us, the little African technate that started off with no technology. But ever since we started, we managed to get quite a lot of tech. Except in the military side, really. But other than that, we made some pretty good progress. We even managed to become the number 13 economy in the world, standing at almost 50 million. And we are number 8 in terms of GDP per capita. We also have one of the most educated populations. We are number 6 in the world, just below Switzerland. Which is quite impressive, considering we have a population of over 11 million people, most of which came here as migrants. As you can see, our country became home of many different cultures, with an especially large Indonesian minority. And we also have people of literally all faiths. Well, anyway, this is the country we managed to create. Those are all the laws I managed to pass. And those are all my institutions. I invested quite a lot in them. Overall, our nation is really prosperous. Except for some reason, our companies really suffered in the last couple years. But anyway, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel for more Victoria 3 A to Z, and I'll see you in the next one.